And this is just to get the last remaining points for Capcom Cut. But if we actually think about how many of the North Americans are left going into the North American Regional Finals, there's about CJ Truth being one of them, Toei is already qualified in it, and then Samurai is the other person, right? Depending on how those three individuals do, or actually the last two, CJ Truth and Samurai, right? Depending on how they do, can really change the influx on who's going to be that last remaining North American player, because Smug is technically also in the cut.
That's definitely true, but that's the whole point, man. The Capcom Pro Tour has definitely built these storylines that means players have to do significantly better, especially in situations like these, if they want to advance. But here we are, Tokido versus John Takeuchi, Lil J-Tac. Let's go.
This is the best way to start off our day. I'll tell you what, we have some of the best competition right here in North American soil. Let's take a look. Game number one starting now.
All right, and already, the respect is already there.
And right off the bat, he saw the animation of that whirlwind shot. Tokido going for that jump and striking first blood, already pushing J-Tac to the corner, trying to fight his way out. Great stuff, the back throw. Now he's in control.
And now you can see J-Tac right now going in. Nice fireball right there to fight out of the corner. Man, Tokido is so good at holding his ground in these corner situations. He's only really willing to call out that EX when he absolutely feels like he needs to. It's very rare chances where Ada's gotten him in trouble, especially situations like that. That's what I mean.
That was the craziest read, because look, if he had got that block, it would have been a done deal, but he knew that J-Tac wanted to go for the throw. He went for the jab DP to go right past it. And again, John Takeuchi, although at a deficit, he's really trying to force Tokido to make the errors, but no.
Little mini shimmy. Man, I love the fact that Tokido is aware enough to say, look, man, I'm trying to close this out. I don't mind spending all of my V meter on these V reversals to stop that Rashid pressure, because even though you're probably still in the same situation, it does not mean that John Takeuchi can attack or that Rashid is plus. The minute you stop him from moving, it's a good chance for you to get your way out of that, you know, very bad situation.
Speaking of bad situations, we're in a very familiar one. Rashid pushing Akuma to the corner, something you see very, very often.
Ugh.
But it's Tokido and John Takeuchi. Tokido very much still trying to fight out the corner. He does so very successfully.
Oh, nice. Completely whiffs. Back to that Nudra game.
No anti-air available.
John Takeuchi fighting back to the middle of the screen. Goes for that trigger to activation. Just run up standing hard kick. Finds a hit. Just backing up. See, now Tokido knows he has to bite his time. That trigger two is draining really slowly for Rashid right now. Tokido on the verge of getting full CA and a full B trigger of his own. Nice dive kick, very rare. Finds his way in, gets the DP, dashes up. Fishing for that standing hard punch target beginner. 44 seconds left on the clock. Full CA available for both these guys. John Takeuchi, a little bit still over half of that V trigger left.
I can't believe it. He hasn't used a single one, Steve. And now, look, he just needs a little bit of life. Both players just need a little bit of life. Could possibly go into critical art. Will this be enough?
No.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm wrong.
Yes, it is.
But I fixed myself.
Yeah,
I fixed myself.
I saw you say it a little bit. I looked right at you, but I'll tell you what, man. It was it's just the way it goes, man. Critical art scaling.
That was actually terrifying. I know what James Chen feels like now. I don't even think he care. He be firing from the hip with the if they're gonna kill. He's like, yo, hand me something to drink. Is it gonna kill? Who knows? That's why we're here. Like,
of course. Look, man, it's an early start for a majority of us, but I'll tell you what, man, Tokido completely on it. And like you mentioned earlier, it was just one more, couple of hits left to get that critical out on.
It's a knockdown. I like the dash up here. I love the way he's using Mixer to control that neutral. Even more so, I love the fact that Tokido isn't budging when it comes to, like, attesting it, right? If John Takeuchi gets in, he lets him keep that ground, and he looks for a proper way out. Nice cross-up, and he gets the corner back with the stun on the very last hit. That man is a genius. DP to get out of the corner. This dude is OD.
Do you see how much meter he built?
OD.
Optimizing the damage, optimizing the meter build. And let's talk about that angle he jumped on J-Tac on. He thought he was going to get the anti-air. He's like, no, son, look. Sharp angle, you're gonna do something else. Maybe fierce spinning mixer. That's not how you do it, though.
Well, that was actually like some CPU max optimization
eight
play
stars.
Right there, bro. Yeah,
that was 8 stars. Gotcha.
Good pressure.
And Takeuchi firing away now. His turn to apply this offense here against Tokido. What are the options that Tokido is going to have to do to get out of this corner?
See, that's what I was exactly talking about. Oh, wow. Nice hard kick into trigger. He's trying to force John Takeuchi to play at this range where he can always have a jab out there or at least throw a fireball, right? And that's gotten him out of so many situations. On top of that, I already spoke about the fact that Tokido is willing to spin that trigger to stop that Rashid offense. And you have to. There's so many people to try to use it as the turnaround option. Speaking of a turnaround option, here's that activation for Tokido. Nice run.
Oh,
and
ran right into it. A lot of damage, slight lead for Kokito, and the frame kill, JTAC fell right for it. He thought he was going to be safe to move on, but no.
Crouch,
finishing it off.
Crouching light punch, crouching medium punch, crouching light again just to make him swing. Such a good call out by Tokido. Man, I'm telling you, that last series was legit so perfect. He did. He got the stun on the very last hit of the Tatsu that switched sides. Did a DP to cross back up out of the corner. Come on, man.
It was really
that
good.
That was actually ridiculous.
Pretty good. It was pretty good. I gotta say, there was a lot of bar. I was looking at his bar because I knew he was going to kill, but I was just looking at his bar to see how much he would build, and man, it was... as Jives would say, optimization station, 100%. And you know, it's very impressive. It's something you could see very often with the likes of Tokido. He's mastered this character and has really innovated this character.
I can tell you right now, man, following John Takeuchi, just the way that he's played, I don't know how many people have noticed. He's made some small changes to his gameplay. He's definitely not as aggressive, or maybe it's just the fact that he's fighting somebody like Tokido, right? Because John Takeuchi definitely has upped his patience. He's upped his respect when it comes to finding those entrances to start his offensive pressure, especially for Rasheed.
And now we got to think about it, right? When he gets his offense going, how does he keep the momentum on his side without having Tokido get these opportunities to escape? Like, how does he keep Tokido locked down? He needs to focus on that a little bit more.
I think it's more of, see how he's putting those normals there? The reason Tokido is backing up is because he's trying to deal with Mixer. He wants to get at the tail end of that ground Mixer, right? But if he thinks there's a fireball, he's going to wait. And that way he can be skill under it just to get out. Like, he has options. That's where the touch and go is. So the neutral is very, very important in this game. You see him back again, Tokido going to that fireball range. And look, just setting out the jab, crouching medium kick to follow too, right? Just like that. Thought he was going to walk into that crouching hard punch. There's the activation off the hard kick. That triggered to such a good option, especially in this matchup for Rasheed. It drains slower. You still get the fear instilled in your opponent.
Yeah, he's going to get this block stun going as well. You saw the counter hit there from John Takeuchi. Tokido pressed the button in between the string, and now John Takeuchi is looking to take this round over Tokido.
Wow.
With the sweep activation. Yeah, EX spinning mixer, a risk he was willing to take.
I don't blame him. He has to get that momentum back because this is round definitely two. First to three. So you have to be careful. Starting off early. Look at him. Like I said, there's the jab, fireball. Crouching medium kick. No, jumps in
and the
jumping hard
again,
punch.
Again, that is the third time we've seen John Takeuchi get his entire stuff. That's all right. Well, three for four.
Mm-hmm. That's how we started the first round.
Oh,
of the first
you
game.
Don't do that. No, not in the corner. And he built so much bar.
Bro, I thought he was gonna get the hit to get the full CA, and I knew he would have spent it if it meant killing him. Set point right now for Tokido. Man, this is looking clinical. My dude came in and gave you a prescription and was like, look, I'm gonna hit you with one of these, one of those, one of them, and I'll see you on the loser's side. Like, that's it.
Best believe, if you need a refill and you ever come back, I got you for that too. That prescription is good for at least the rest of the year.
Tokido's always down for seconds, especially when it comes to beating you. Like that, he's like, yo, I'm down for this.
He's getting ready for the holiday season.
All right, dash up, tries to go for the throw. Good patience. There's that activation again. Such a good option to activate off of that standing hard kick. Tries to go for the mix of changes.
Oh, he tried it, but that's the problem. He's changing the trajectory with the demon.
Wow.
The dive kick.
Yeah, and like you said before, like using that dive kick to change the trajectory is something we typically do not see Tokido. He very rarely pulls that out, and is very effective in his matchup, as you can see right there.
It's really messed with John Takeuchi's anti-air timing, really. Keeping it as ambiguous as possible to close the gap and get his offense going alongside having a ton of damage on the board. Full critical art stocked for both players. But again, if Tokido lands this hit, it's pretty much lights out. John Takeuchi just needs a little bit more life to shave off of Tokido's life bar, and he's looking to do so now. No more critical art left for John Takeuchi. And there it is. That should be all she wrote. That's gotta be it. Threatsuha. And that is it.
He actually says, see ya. What's up? See ya.
Yeah. I honestly think he says, see ya. Like, yeah. You know.
That would be too cool. Mm. Akuma would go up a lot of cool points if he actually said, see ya.
He's been hanging out with a lot of Americans during this tour as well.
I believe it. That's Tokido, man. Tokido is Murderfist. That's how you know he's been hanging out too much with the Americans, man. I've seen Tokido more than I've seen my mom this year. It's crazy.
These are actually
facts. That's facts.
These are
man.
Actually facts.
It's the regular Miranda. I'm like, hey, Tokido, how's it going? He's like, hello.
Tasty.
Tasty still.